would testify to bring glory to their King. How I love to hear the stories, how the Lord brought victory. But how happy I'll be when eternally I'll hear the untold stories. Untold stories of His grace that He poured out on the saints. Untold stories of His love and His healings from above. How He brought us through this world, remaining true and fire-filled. How He helped us when we were down, setting our feet on solid ground. What testifying there will be, the untold story.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Week 9. Hard to believe, but here we are, and we're gathered together to worship the Lord. Amen. Let's open our service in prayer. Lord, thank You, Jesus, that we could come together, Lord, in this parking lot today, Lord, to give You praise and glory. We ask You, Lord, You would touch every person represented here, every family, and Lord, that You would minister Your grace unto us. Lord, we lift up Your name. We ask You, Lord, that You would take control of this service. Lord, that You would anoint Your servant from on high. We thank You, Lord, and we give You the praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. We're going to sing Praise Him. Praise Him. Praise God.
Praise Him, praise Him, Jesus.
concerned about your needs. So let's go to the Lord in prayer and believe right now that God will touch. Amen? Hallelujah. Just throw a hand up right where you're at. Call on Him right now. Lord, we are a needy people. We are a very needy people. God, it just seems like the world is coming unhinged. But we know that You're in control. And Lord, You said that these are the signs of Your coming. So Lord, we prepare our hearts right now that we would be ready for the return of Jesus Christ. We pray for every family member that God, You would come down, You would speak, You would move, You would answer prayers, Lord. Hallelujah. Today, as we lift them up to You, Lord, for every sick person we lift up right now in the name of Jesus, Lord, we mention their names, Lord. They're in our minds right now. And God, we say, Lord, in Jesus' name, let Your hand touch these, those that are in the hospital, those that are home, those that are here may not feel 100%, God. Let there be a touch today of healing. Lord, we thank You that You took the stripes upon Your back for our healing. And Lord, we just ask You to move upon each person here, God. Hallelujah. And Lord, if there be one that finds themselves away from You, let them have assurance, God, as they turn to You today, that God, You have saved them. And Lord, You are moving in their lives. Let them turn everything over to You. Lord, we pray for the little children during this time, the little babies. Oh, God, cover them with the precious blood. Lord, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, hallelujah. Lord, reach out and touch these, hallelujah, by Your grace and power. And thank You for this church and everyone that's here today. We just pray, God, this service would be a blessing to them, that they'd be lifted up. I plead the blood of Jesus Christ over every situation. And I ask, God, You come down, Lord, in every part of their lives, Lord, and let them receive that touch right now. Receive it. Say, Lord, I receive it. I receive it in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I receive healing in Jesus' name. Thank You, Lord. Just thank You right now. Just say, thank You, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Praise the name of Jesus. Thank You, Lord, for healing our land. Praise God. In Jesus' name.
Amen. God's goodness and faithfulness is with us today, and I feel that reassurance. I feel the presence of the Lord here today. And His assurance to know that through every storm, through every valley, through every situation that we face, hallelujah, I'm going to depend on the word of the Lord. Amen. His word is what's going to see us through. Praise the Lord. And I'm thankful, hallelujah, that we're here at the house of the Lord. Amen. Hoping soon that we'll be able to be in the house of the Lord. Praise God. But I'm thankful today, and I'm thankful for all these weeks that we've been able to have church out here in this parking lot, and that You were able to be here to receive of that word. Praise the Lord. God is on the throne. Amen. And though storms may come through times of discouragement, or maybe you're just feeling chaos and confusion, I want you to know you can find peace of mind. Amen. You can find rest and assurance in the word of the Lord today and know that He is with us. I want to read a Psalms 47 to you today. It says, oh, clap your hands, all ye people. Shout unto God with a voice of triumph. For the Lord Most High is terrible. He is a great king over all the earth. He shall subdue the people under us, and the nations under our feet. He shall choose our inheritance for us, the excellency of Jacob, whom He loved. God is gone up with a shout. the Lord with the sound of a trumpet. Sing praise to God. Sing praises. Sing praises unto our King. Sing praises. For God is the King of all the earth. Sing ye praises with understanding. God reigneth over the heathen. God sitteth upon the throne of his holiness. The princes of the people are gathered together, even the people of the God of Abraham. For the shields of the earth belong unto God. He is greatly exalted. Hallelujah. We praise you, Jesus. We glorify your name. Hallelujah. And we thank you, Jesus, that, Lord, we are here, Lord, in your presence, Lord. For God, your word tells us we have come in your name. And, Lord, when we come in the name of the Lord, we know that you are in the midst, Lord. You are here, Lord, and you're wanting to do wonderful works in our lives. We are thankful today. And right there in your vehicle, I want you to lift up holy hands unto the Lord and thank the Lord right now and bless his name. Lord, we thank you and we praise you, Jesus. And we thank you, Lord, and we sing praises unto your name. And we bless you, Lord, because you are worthy of our praise. We lift you up high, Lord, and we know, God, that when we lift you up, Lord Jesus, Lord, you will draw all men unto you, Lord. God, we praise you today, and Lord, we ask, Lord, that each one that is here today, by the listening of my voice, I pray that your spirit, Lord, I pray that your glory and your power will go, Lord, with them and touch them right where they're at, Lord, where their need is, Lord. I know that you are greater, hallelujah. I know, God, that your word is true and your word is powerful, Lord. And I pray right now that your presence and your spirit be with us today. We give you thanks. We give you praise. In Jesus' name, hallelujah. And we say amen and amen. Hallelujah. We glorify this Savior. This Psalms I was reading, and it just lifted my spirit even in the time of, you know, discouragement, or even in the time where, you know, I needed to trust in the word of the Lord. This scripture comes to me and lets me know in all situations, amen, in all times, it says, at all times there will continually be praise on my mouth. Hallelujah. There's supposed to be praise on your lips today. And I'm going to give him the praise and I'm going to give him the glory. You know, in the midst of all that's going on in our lives, I want you to know that we need to look to the Lord. And I want you to know, in the midst of your storm, in the midst of confusion, in the midst of fear, lift your hands and praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I want you to know, if there's one thing the devil hates, is when you lift up your hands unto God and you giving the praise. Hallelujah. Now, this psalmist got it right when he said, clap your hands. Now, you wonder why we clap our hands in church? Now, it's not just to do it. No, there's a reason why we do it. Because I have the joy of the Lord. I've been saved. I've been redeemed. Hallelujah. My sins are under the blood of Jesus Christ. And my name is written down in the Lamb's Book of Life. And I have a reason to clap my hands. I have a reason to lift up my voice and to shout unto God with a voice of triumph. Why? Because it's the reason. It's because of God that I have the victory, that I have triumph today because of what Christ has done for you and me. Don't let the devil steal your joy. Don't let the devil steal your praise. Don't let the devil come against you and to take away what God has done in your life. No, lift up your hands, hallelujah, and look up to the heavens. your praise. Hallelujah. He is worthy of your praise. Why? Because I want you to know God is seated on his throne today. God is the one in charge. Now I want you to know we've got all kinds of leadership in our nation. We can look to those sources, but I want you to know those sources will fail you. But the one that will never fail you is God. God is seated in the heavens. Hallelujah. And I want you to know he will come to your rescue. He will not forsake you. He will not leave you comfortless. No, but he would send the power of the Holy Ghost. He would give you the victory, and he would give you the power to overcome the enemy. Thank God that we can lift our voice in praise. I want you to know, don't let the enemy steal your praise today. Don't let the enemy steal your victory. It's up to you. You know, they talk about having a mindset of what you're going to do. Well, I want you to know, you better have a mindset for God. You better get your mind on the right things. I want you to know things, you know, when this all started happening, and I was like, my goodness, I've got more people in the parking lot than I've had in the church for a while. Why? Because it's an awakening for us. This is a window for us that we would see, even when things slowly, maybe they come back to normal. It's not for you to go back to the way that you were. But no, it's for you to look to Jesus Christ. It's for you to draw closer to him. It's for you to receive more power. It's for you to receive more joy, more praise, and more victory in your life. Receive of the power of his Spirit. Let the Holy Ghost come into your heart and in your mind, because God is seated high. Hallelujah. As it says in verse 2, for the Lord Most High is terrible. He is a great king over all the earth. I know that this world system, they are going to depend on the way that things go in this nation. And I want you to know we're all praying and believing. I want you to know I have hope. I don't have to worry about the things that are going on in this nation. No, I can put my trust in the Savior because I have an inheritance with him. I've been saved. I've been blood-bought. He has ripped the fear. He has ripped the sin. He has taken all those things out of my life. And I've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. And I can look to him. I can pray to him. You know, we were just thinking the other day, you know, how some, they don't care about when you go out in public about, you know, wearing masks, or whether you do or whether you don't, or the fear of getting the virus. I know that it's out there. I know that it's happened to good people, and it's happened, you know, to the unbeliever or whoever, and it's happened to the believer. I've even heard of some pastors that have passed away from it. Dear God, we need the grace of God. But I am thankful that in anything in my life, storm or valley in my life that I go through, I can put my trust in the one that has created me, the one that has formed this land, the one that puts the stars in the sky, hallelujah, and lets that sun set low, that the moon will shine in the night, and in the morning when it rises, the sun rises back up. I want you to know how much more does he care for you and me. How much more? Hallelujah. We can look to him and know, hallelujah, that we've been redeemed. And the reason that I might get emotional or I might be stirred in my spirit this morning is because I've been there. I know what is. I want you to know not everything is peaches and cream all the time for me. And it's not for you. I want you to know the things that you're going through. We're all going through it. We're trusting in the Lord to see us through this thing. As the song says, through it all, I've learned to trust in Jesus. I've learned to trust in God. I'm going to depend on the mighty word of God. And that's why it's so vital that you're here to hear the word of God. I was so concerned because I know, yes, I've heard it a million times with all this. The church is not a building. It's a people. It's, you know, I want you to know it's very vital that you're here in the house of God. Don't you let the enemy lie to you. Don't let the enemy lie to you to think that it's not important that we are the church when we come together in faith. If we're all at home doing our own thing, where is that going to get us? It's when we come together. A little illustration I saw on the news this week. It showed almost 100 Amish men that they got under this barn and they carried it to the destination from point A to point B. Now I want you to know, not one little Amish man could have done that all by himself. It took a body to do that. Amen? Come on, let me hear you. It took a body to do that. You can't do this thing all on your own. You need the believer. You need the house of God. You need the word of God. And you need to come into the presence of the Lord. And you need to be in the presence of God, lifting your hands, shouting unto God, giving him the praise. Because I want you to know that's where your victory comes from. That's how you get the victory. Don't let us on the, you know, where I don't have to go to church. I can stay home and I got, yeah, God is with you, but I want you to know you need to be in the house of God. Whether we're in the parking lot or whether we're in the building, we need each other. And we need the presence of God. And we need to thank him, because I want you to know when it's all said and done, he's King of Kings and he's Lord of Lords. He was from the start and he will be to the finish. It says Psalms 29:10, the Lord sitteth upon the flood. Yea, the Lord setteth king forever. I know we put presidents in and we take presidents out. We put congressmen in and we put congressmen and women out. But I want you to know it is God that is seated high on his throne today, and he reigneth king forever and ever. Hallelujah. And I'm going to give him the praise. I'm going to give him the glory. Now I know, and I want you to know it's not always easy to praise him. There's going to be times where you have nothing to give, where you have nothing in your life to give. And I want you to know, even in those times, God is calling for you to lift up your hands and just say, Lord, I thank you. Lord, I give you the praise. Hallelujah. As it says in Psalm 7:17, it says, I will praise the Lord according to his righteousness. Not according to how you feel today. No, according to God's righteousness and his holiness, as it says in the scriptures, as he sitteth upon his throne with all holiness. He's a holy God. He's a just God, and he will not forsake you. He's righteous. It says, and I will sing praise to the name of the Lord Most High. Psalms 67 says, let the people praise thee. O God, let all the people praise the Lord. Let the joy of the Lord, praise is lifted high. Why? Because we want everyone, hallelujah. I don't want to keep this thing to myself. No, I'm going to tell the believer. I'm going to tell the unbeliever. I'm going to thank God, because I know one day I was in the miry clay. I know I couldn't get myself out. But Jesus, in his love and his mercy, news come from the heart and you cry out for help, I want you to know he's going to come to your rescue. He's going to lift you up. I know in faith and in praise, you know, I was listening to John Hagee. I even shared it there on Facebook, and he talked about how he was born right in the midst of World War II. And, you know, there was a lot of things that said the news, the newspapers, everything was filled with the war. You know, that can bring a fear, and that can bring, thoughts, you know. Even as a little boy, he said, he'd see up and he said his mother looked at him, and he said, she said it with authority. She said, John, God is with us. And I want you to know, God is with us through this virus. He's with us through the sickness. He's with us through the trials and the tribulations. And I want you to know, he talked about how we need to press forward. And even our children, we need to let them know in faith that God is with them. And I want you to know, let your kids see you lifting up holy hands, praising the Lord in season and out of season, no matter what the season is. Lift up your hands and giving the praise, for the Lord is with you today. The Lord is with you. We will praise him. I read there in the scriptures where it says that, yeah, Jesus came into Jerusalem and they cried, Hosanna. Later down in that scripture, it talks about where he went into the temple, and there where they were using the temple for terrible things, selling and you know, it wasn't on the right things. It wasn't to pray and to glorify the Lord. They were selling. They were just using it as a place of business. I want you to know, this isn't a place of business. This is a place where you can receive God in your life. You can receive salvation. You can receive healing. Hallelujah. You can receive deliverance for your soul today. That's what this place is for. But it says when Jesus went out of that temple that there were children there, and they began to cry out, and they began to praise him, and they began to say, Hosanna, Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, the Son of David, they cried. And it says that all the others, it says that all the others that were around that just had a form of godliness, it says that they were displeased. They didn't, they looked at it as something that was wrong. Jesus said to his disciples, it says, have you never read, out of the mouth of babes and sucklings, thou hast perfected praise? In that illustration, I saw a picture of a newborn baby that I have to say, I never saw anything like it in my life. And that baby, if that wasn't real, I mean, it looked a true blue. That baby, there was that mother in the hospital with that baby in the crib. And she was singing a glory and praise song to her baby. And that baby had its arms, now not real high, but they were up just enough like he was praising the Lord. And I want you to know, I believe that he was. I believe that he was praising the Lord. He was lifting his hand, as it says in the scripture, out of the mouth of babes. Out of the mouth of babes, God has perfected praise. Hallelujah. We can lift up our voice unto him. We can shout with a voice of triumph. We can know, hallelujah, in everything, God is our King, and we will praise him with the understanding. Why? Because we understand that it's because of Jesus and his love and his mercy and grace that has saved us, that has redeemed us. The devil, the main thing that he will try to take from you is your praise. I want you to know, you don't have to be ashamed anymore. You can lift up your hands and you can pray. you. And if there's any way that you're going to get the victory, is when you begin to worship him in spirit and in truth. Lifting your hands and glorifying the Savior. I saw where the governor of Kentucky, I guess they allowed the churches to go back to church. But there was all these stipulations. And when I heard it, I just had to laugh a little bit because I thought, my goodness, do they really hear? Do they really, how ridiculous it sounds. They said, you can go to church, but no congregational singing. Dear God, if you take the praise out, what do you have? We need to lift our voices high. We need to praise his holy name. If there's anything that the devil wants to take from you, the one thing that he would like to take away from the house of God is the praises of the Lord's people. Well, we're going to shout unto God. We're going to know that even in times of storms and tribulations, as I was reading there in the book of Acts, Paul and Silas were put into prison. They were in prison. And Shannon said, we have heard of those that have been put into prison just because they want to work. I want you to know when it gets to the place where with things like this going on, we've got to know that even in tribulation and storms of our lives, we've got to lift up praise unto God. That even some would say, well, why would God allow them to be thrown into the prison? Well, I want you to know, because this world is full of evil people. This world is not full of everyone that has the power of God and allows the Spirit of the Lord to move in their life. That's why we've got to stand strong and we've got to be like those Amish men. We're not going to get it done just with one, but we're going to get it done when we all come together in faith. When we all come together, and that's just the way that it was. And I think, my goodness, God had a plan. Even while they were in prison, they lifted up their voices and they began to praise and to sing praises unto God. And it says that there was an earthquake and their shackles were broken and they were free. I want you to know it's an illustration to you today. When you lift up hands praising the Lord and singing glory unto our God, I want you to know those shackles, those strongholds of the enemy, the fear, the confusion, the doubt, and the worry will fall to the ground. And you'll be able to glorify the Savior. And I think even in the midst of that, that wasn't the most powerful part of the story. It was the part that when the jailer saw that they were all free, he was good. He's like, I'm going to get in trouble here. I might as well just end this thing. But Paul cried out and said, don't do any harm to yourself. And that jailer came to them and he said, what must I do to be saved? The greatest miracle of all is when you receive of the Lord Jesus Christ and you repent and you turn to him with all of your heart. And that day that jailer was saved. And not only was he saved, but his household was saved. That's why it's so important that we glorify him, that we praise his name, not just in church, but wherever we are. Lift up the Savior, praising his name and giving him the glory. In the times where you don't know or you don't feel God is with you, I want you to know his word will sustain you. His word will lift you up. And no, not everyone around you may not understand why you're praising him. You just keep pulling and praising him. I was reading there in the scriptures where David danced before the Lord. They had brought the Ark of the Covenant back and he began to praise and lift up his voice and dance before the Lord. And it says, as it says in verse 9. It says, the princes of the people are gathered together, and the people of God of Abraham. For the shields of the earth belong unto God. God will not forsake his people. As it says in Psalms 29, the Lord will give strength unto his people. The Lord will bless his people with peace. I want you to know, God has done the victory for you. He has paid the price. As it said here in the scriptures, says that God has gone up with a shout, the Lord with the sound of a trumpet. I want you to know that's foretelling that Jesus, hallelujah, he would ascended into heaven, hallelujah. He went back, but I want you to know, you can read it there in the book of Acts. He went up, and the reason that he went up with victory and with power is because he paid the price for you. He bled and died on an old wooden cross for you so that you didn't have to be bound by sin. And he raised from the dead, and it says in the scriptures that he said that he would come back. The angels declared and said, when they looked up into the heavens and they saw Jesus going back up into the sky, the angels declared and said, ye men of Galilee, why ye stand gazing unto the heaven? The same Jesus which is taken up from you into heaven shall come in like manner as ye have seen him go into heaven. He went up with a shout, but I want you to know, he's coming back with a shout. He's coming back with the trumpet, hallelujah. And I want you to know, that's our victory shout, hallelujah. That's what I'm looking forward to. That's what I got my eyes set upon, hallelujah. He's coming back for his church. The ones that have praised him through the storm. The ones that held close to him and lifted up their voice and magnified him and blessed him. I want you to know, don't lose hope. Don't lose the victory. Don't let the devil steal your praise. Don't let him steal your joy. And don't let him steal your victory. Because Jesus is coming back. Hallelujah. He's coming back to take us away. Hallelujah. We won't have to mess around with his old dark world of sin anymore. Hallelujah. He's going to come and take us out of here. I want to be in that number. And all the more when I get to the other side, I want you to know, the more that I see down here in this world, I'm looking at things and I'm seeing things and I'm saying, this is from another world. This is something that I would have never imagined in all my born days. But I'm thinking, Lord, heaven sounding sweeter all the time. Heaven is sounding sweeter all the time. Make your reservation plan. Make sure, get in that number. Stay close to God. Lift up those hands and glorify the Savior, because I want you to know, it's your victory today. Hallelujah. Let's pray. Lord, we thank you. We praise you. And we thank you, Lord, for the victory. We thank you, Lord, that you have all power in your hands. Hallelujah. And Lord, we want to glorify you. We want to praise your name. Hallelujah. And we know that we begin to praise you and thank you for all that you have done, Lord. Lord God, you will come, Lord, to our defense. You will come, Lord, with great power. You will come and bring that life-giving source to us. Your mighty word. We thank you today for your power and your presence. And I pray for each one that is here, every person in every vehicle here today. I pray by the sounding of my voice, they would feel the power of the Holy Ghost. And Lord, if there's anyone here that needs to turn to you, repent and be saved, I pray they would cry out to you for help. Lord, you will save them. You will deliver them. Lord, if there's one here in need of healing right now, in the name of Jesus, we praise you. We thank you, Lord. Lord, that by your stripes, we are healed. And we thank you, Lord, for that healing today. Lord, go with your people. Lord, let them be moved, oh God, to glorify you and to bless your name.